Talks, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The Panthers have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And he's taken down at the 39. He fights forward to about the 40. So the halfback steams ahead for only about a yard, but it's still a first down.
I think that's the third time he's carried the ball on this drive. And I can imagine they'll keep giving it to this guy until the defense can figure out how to stop him.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 40. He tackles him for a loss.
The defense was able to get really good penetration and drop him short of the line of scrimmage.
Completes it, and he's hit hard immediately. But he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Tackled at about the 49. Well, a new quarterback, but we saw this kid getting reps both in practice and in the pregame walkthrough, so this isn't a big surprise. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it.
Mike Ford, Mike Ford! Cal! Blue 19!
They keep it on the ground with the tailback, and he hits him hard at the 19-yard line.
That'll bring up second and 11.
We've got a second and 11. Ball on the 19. They'll spread the field with five wide. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
To the 40. He's at midfield. Inside the 30. To the 10. Touchdown!
Wow. When you see that end zone in front of you, it can elevate your running to another level. Awesome play.
He makes the PAT. So a short three-play, 80-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Well, Brad, right now this offense is hot, and they also took advantage of some mistakes there by the defense.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Tackle made at the 29-yard line. The Bearcats are right where they want to be early in this one.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. And he's tackled at about the 39-yard line. From their own 39-yard line. It's first down. Got some open field. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That'll make it second and four.
So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's got the corner. Takes the ball right. He gets hit out of bounds around the 39-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air with a play-action pass.
From the 38-yard line. Second down. And he's going to be sacked.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now. This quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The last time we saw this offense on the field, they drove the length of the field. And you think back to what that defensive coordinator tried to do. He tried to change some things up, but nothing seemed to work. It's going to be interesting to see how he can have an impact on this drive.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. From their own 24-yard line. It's second down. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. One quarter. The Bearcats lead 7-0. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
Second and 13. From their own 29-yard line. Second down.
Mike four.
to his receiver.
He's at midfield. Inside the 30. The 10. And a huge touchdown play. A four-play, 79-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys got to be coming over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Brought down at the 41. And the delayed handoff works for a big game.
Got to be happy with the effort there by your tailback.
First and 10. Ball on their own 41.
Three down. Mike four.
Tackle at the 49-yard line.
Brings him down. Gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
He goes at the 41-yard line.
Gain of 10 yards. First down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 41-yard line. Excellent open field tackle.
That's a gain of 12 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
Caught, open field, inside the 10, and he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a first and goal.
Yeah, the defense looked a little sluggish there. They can do better than that.
That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. After a decent run up the gut.
Gain of 4 on the gut. That brings him second and goal.
And he tackles him hard at the 6.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
It's third and goal from the 5. Let's see if they can put this one in. Knocked out of bounds around the 4-yard line. The play fake good for only a couple.
That brings us fourth and goal.
Kicks up, and it's Quincy uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's out to the 30. He makes it to the 35-yard line. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. It and he stops short of the line of scrimmage.
That's a loss of 2 yards. That'll bring up second and 12.
It's second and 12. Ball on their own 33.
Mike eight.
Run left, and he's taken down in the backfield. The Panthers had one of their key players go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the lineup. He's under some heat. Airing it out long. He's picked it off. This time it's the safety.
Just when it looked like this offense might be able to put this game out of reach, you turn the football over with an interception? Boy, this could come back in a big way to bite you.
They line up at the 12. First down. Quick pass. He's taken down right around the 12-yard line. The screen pass goes nowhere.
Well, you got to take your hat off to the defense. All week, they preached over and over again how they were not going to let this kid use his speed in the open field, and they really shut him down that time.
And they make the stop at the 19. Fires quickly, and he's got his man.
Makes the set at the 19-yard line. That makes it third and three.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They got to him, and he did not get the first down. And they just stuffed that one.
Hey, this is a great play here by the defense to bring him down before he could get to the sticks.
Booming kick. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. The Bearcats are just cruising through this first half, Herbie. Really a comfortable lead here.
Yep, but still a lot of football left to be played. They got to remember that it's a four-quarter game, and even though that first half went pretty well, things can change in a hurry.
And the offense will take the field, and they're certainly hoping to do better than they did on their last drive, which ended with a turnover.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out. I wouldn't be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to fluster this quarterback some more. The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that.
As they head to the locker rooms, this one is far from over. The Bearcats in front by 11.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game.
It is my job to come in and rain on a parade. I know everything's gone right. I know they have all the momentum. I know that every little detail of the game plan has gone exactly as scripted. But overconfidence, too happy, too satisfied. How big a problem is that in the second half?
But you always have the excitement coming in the first half of a ball game, and you think it's going to be close when teams like this are evenly matched. But that doesn't mean you can lose your edge. That doesn't mean you can get complacent. A lot of times we see passion and energy in the first half, and it starts to wither away. They got to make sure that they keep the energy up, continue to make plays. Don't think that you're there, because we've seen momentum switch like that. As soon as somebody flips a switch, it's hard to get it going back in the other direction. So you got to take advantage of these opportunities.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Taken down right around the 28-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From their own 28-yard line, second down. Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
Get him in the backfield.
Number 32. Receiver on the play. Fourth down.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. And this one is a beauty. He's tackled at the 38-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. He fights forward to about the 49.
Gain of three on the play. First down.
Tight right, tight right, tight right. Still out there, check it out.
Nice run up the middle. Second down and five. Ball on the 46-yard line. He's at the 30. He's pushed out of bounds around the 25-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 21 yards. First down.
Him down in the backfield.
That's a loss of 4 yards. That makes it second and 14.
Second and 14. Ball on the 29-yard line. They'll bring him down at the 16-yard line. He's in for the touchdown. And he tacks on the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. The offense will be hoping for a little more success than they had the last time out. Got an opening. to the 40. Makes it out to about the 43.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
First and 10. Ball on their own 43. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
And he's level at the 37. Defense hoping for another sack here on third and long. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Great concentration to haul it in, and he's tackled at the 47-yard line.
That'll make it fourth and six.
And here's the, wait a minute, the upback's got it. They'll bring him down at the 49. Unable to convert on fourth down, and the ball changes hands. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he's stopped behind the line. From their own 49-yard line. Second down. That's a great tackle at the 45-yard line.
That makes it third and 15.
He is drilled at the 34-yard line.
That was a loss of 7 yards on the play. That makes it 4th and 9.
The sack makes this a 4th and very long. He really got a hold of that one. From the 15. Tackle at the 26. Nice yardage on the run back. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Nice run there.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five. Ball on the 31-yard line. Tackle made right around the 42-yard line. We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. The Bearcats lead it by four. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Four down. Mike, four. Blue 78.
There's a play fake. Throws to the right to his fullback.
A part of any quarterback's arsenal should be the ability to sell the run with a good fake. He does a really good job here on the fake, and then they pick up some nice yards.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 46. Brought down around the 47-yard line.
Loss of field. That'll bring up second and 11.
Double tight, guys. Double tight. Four down, four down.
And he's got all the time in the world. He sails it long. And he hits him hard to the 19-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 19-yard line. Gets out to about the 18-yard line. The running back picks up a yard on the counter.
Second and nine.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down. Mike four, Mike four.
Inside the 10. And a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A seven-play, 73-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. They line up to kick this one away. He's out to the 30. And he makes it out to about the 37-yard line. I have a feeling we haven't seen the end of the fireworks today.
They need to move the ball down the field quickly and efficiently. They should maybe even throw in some no huddle to conserve time.
They're set to go for another round. Throws it in a hurry. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 41.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Second down and six. Ball on the 41-yard line. He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Just throws this one away. So they're going to go for it here. Got him. They tried to throw for it, but ended up getting sacked.
I think they had to go for it given the circumstances. They just couldn't pull it off.
The offense just wasn't able to make a play. The defense was really clutch right there. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. And it carries the ball for a nice game.
That's good for 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
From the 34-yard line, it's second down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Yards there on the counter.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. Third down.
Right around the 26-yard line.
You know, on these shorter distances to pick up the first down, it's basically the offensive line matching up against the defensive line. And on that particular conversion, the offensive line did a nice job of getting just enough of a push to give the back enough room for the first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 15. And he's in the end zone. Touchdown. Big time touchdown on the ground for what looks to be the score that puts this one on ice. And he adds the extra point. So that's a five-play, 38-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
And, Brad, right now the offensive line just winning the battle in the trenches, opening up some big running lanes.
The score now, 28-10. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. They went for it on fourth down on their last possession and weren't successful.
Hey, Brad, remember the last time this offense came out of the field? Of course, they went for it on fourth down. Sometimes it drives me crazy when we call all of these games and these guys out here go for it all the time on fourth down. Here's a message. If it's longer than fourth and five, just consider a field goal or a punt.
Just under two to go in the game. He chucks it downfield. And down he goes at the 41. And he throws it away. From the 41-yard line, second down. Five wide. Receiver's got the first down. He's taken down right around the 20. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Short pass, middle of the field. He's tackled around the 15-yard line.
That brings him second and five.
Spikes the ball.
That'll make it third and five.
From the 15-yard line, it's third down. Throws quickly into the end zone. Caught for the touchdown. Catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And the secondary didn't quite seem alert enough to defend that pass. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Well, I think the play warranted a review, but the call on the field stands. And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. Watch out for a pass play when you're in a goal line D. They got it.
Kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
You know, there are a lot of things that can go wrong on an onside kick, but still kicking the ball out of bounds is one of the last things you'd be worried about.
And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Up the middle for a nice game. The Panthers using their third and last timeout. We've got a second and five. Ball on the 42-yard line. They make the stop, the 39-yard line. 3-yard gain by the halfback on the counter play.
That'll bring up third and two.
Taken down around the 42-yard line.
The defense was playing the run all the way, and they They got it right. Nice work.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Panthers, I'm sure, are secure in the knowledge that despite this setback today, they still have one of the best players in the country.
Well, this is a devastating loss, but it's one that they're going to have to put behind them. And as you said, they still have one of the best players in the country. They don't need to deviate their plan. Get back to really what they know, and that's getting the ball to their star player. Next week, I'm sure they'll be fine.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.